Hey, here we are. People of Earth, how are you? Good evening and welcome to episode 114 of the House Arrest Concert Series from Mount Laurel, New Jersey, with me, your host and solo performer, Bill Spence. Nice and cold. I was on a 3-week schedule because last weekend I was at my 50th high school reunion. And it was a lot of fun, I'll tell you the truth. And even though this first number came out the year after I graduated, I still often think of it when I think of my old school. Taped together. I'm going to move this over here and check the recording device and see who's texting me in the middle of my program. Recording device is there. Lots of people watching. Hey, Florida checking in. Thank you so much. North Jersey checking in.
and South Jersey checking in. And was the text that noise we heard? Yes, my text is a crow. Let me just take a look and see. I don't know if that carried over, but last text said, "Oh shit, it's Facebook Live time." So people know me. And people love me, and you know, I'm good enough. 50 years, baby. I'll talk about what day it is and other trivia and stuff. My old school from Steely Dan, from Countdown to Ecstasy, their second album, 1973. It was actually released as a single and hit number 63. It's kind of the tale about getting ratted out by a female acquaintance. Donald Fagen and 43 others were arrested in Annandale at Bard College, where they went. You know, they were smoking with the boys upstairs. But, you know, it happens. You got a good song out of it, Don. And there you go. Today is National Pumpkin Spice Day. And I mean, that's fine. It's October 1st. I'm good with pumpkin spice now. I mean, it's ginger, cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice, and clove. Those are the pumpkin spices. And I actually bought some because I made little pumpkin pie tartlets. Gonna make some tomorrow. Anyway, Pumpkin Spice Day. It's also National Hair Day. For me, unfortunately, it's National Bad Hair Day. And it's Homemade Cookies Day. So I didn't make anything today, but like I said, tartlets are a coming. This week, we always seem to lose some musical legends in the weeks that I'm off, and this week is no exception. Coolio passed away a couple of days ago at the age of 59. I remember Coolio, obviously, from Gangster's Paradise, but mostly I remember him from the intro to the Keenan and Kel show. Nickelodeon in the 90s. Yeah. Good stuff. Also, this week, a couple days ago, Louise Fletcher, Nurse Ratched from One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. She was 88 years old. Speaking of birthdays, today is Zach Galifianakis' birthday. He's 53. Julie Andrews is 87. Brie Larson is 33. I was just watching Brie Larson this afternoon at the Captain Marvel movie. Switching between that and watching the Phillies circle the drain. Speaking of baseball, on this day in 1961, Roger Maris hit his 61st home run. Aaron Judge did not hit his 62nd today. They kept breaking into college football to show that whenever he batted. Speaking of going up to bat, in 1962, the bat was taken from Jack Parr and given to Johnny Carson. The Tonight Show. This was the first episode with him as a host. Back in 1955, the first episode of The Honeymooners debuted. First of 39 classic episodes. And in 1908, the first of 15 million Model Ts left the assembly line. And hey, that's all the stuff that I need to say. So I'm going to continue playing some songs. A couple of them are school related because that's, you know, been on my mind. I was kind of hoping I might see a teacher or two at this reunion. I mean, yeah, we're all like in our late 60s, but some of our teachers were only 5 or 6 years older than us at the time, and you know, would have been nice, you know. And I would have sung. I would have been a Lulu girl. That with the Mindbenders, a band from Manchester, whom you may have heard of as backing band for Wayne Fontana, and you know, kind of a mid-60s English beat band, and they had a couple hits, but To Start With Love with Lulu, who was the second Scottish female. The first Scottish female to hit number one, second British female to hit number one in 1965, Petula Clark, and then in 1981, Sheena Easton, the second Scottish female, hit number one. Anyways, that's what I know. I never went to a prom or homecoming. Neither did Janice Ian. She felt a little conflicted about it, writing this song. She was inspired by a New York Times article by a girl who was 18, who was going to a debutante ball and hoping that would make her feel better about her life, and it turns out it didn't. Janice Ian, like I said, went to no prom, went to no homecoming. And at 23, she heard this song, which went to number 3 in 1975. I actually met and interviewed her in 1975. She was touring for this album. Great song. Learned the truth at 17, that love was meant for beauty queens, and high school girls with clear skin smiles, who married young and then retired.
Girls like me, we all play the game, and when we do-
Last of the school-related tunes for this evening. It's hit number 3 in 1975, by the way. This song for the Drifters hit number 5 in 1963. Jerry Goffin says this is the favorite lyric he's ever written. Carole King suggested that the title be My Secret Place, and Jerry actually came up with some better lyrics. Instead of My Secret Place, it's Up on the Roof. Scenes in West Side Story when he wrote that. Carole King also did this solo version of this on her 1970 debut writer. It's the one before Tapestry. Anyway, so you're up on the roof. I'm in trouble. seen some high-line places. I come down to smoking and ash. We love our loathing, but not like we love our freedom. This is why my text alert is a cawing crow, because I don't like getting texts, but I'm gonna see who's bugging me.
Hello. Okay. More people have logged on. The broadcast may stop for a sec while I check the text. Work, and they report to me, and I'm gonna fire every one of them. Don't they know? Whatever. All right, I got a few more songs to do. It's 8 o'clock already, but you know, when you go on every 3 weeks, you build up a lot of pressure, and you need to release it. 1, 2, 3, 4. There was a band in the late 60s, 1969, a band called the Fifth Avenue Band. They were friends with and produced by Zal Yanofsky and Jerry Yester from the Love and Spoonful. This is the album. This is the album, and they were good-looking guys, huh? Yeah. The dude with the cap in the purple shirt is named John Lind, and he was actually pretty prolific and good songwriter. He wrote such songs as Boogie Wonderland for Earth, Wind, and Fire, Crazy for You for Madonna. He didn't write this song, but he sang it, and I've always loved this song from the Fifth Avenue Band, One Way or the Other. Changes
things that don't ever turn out right. Well, it's either one way or the other. And I forgot how nice it always was when you were here to see that everything I loved with you made me feel with every smile. And ever since you left, it still was new. But timeless love in you was wearing me down. And I forgot how nice it always was when you were here. Living love, loving life, are as far apart as they can be.
The Netflix program Stranger Things, I'm woefully behind on it, but apparently this newest season features some music from Kate Bush. It's Running Up That Hill, which is a great song. But a greater song, I think, came before that in 1980 from her Never Forever LP. And it goes like this. She wanted to test her husband. She knew exactly what to do. A pseudonym to fool him. She couldn't have made a worse move. She sent him scented letters, and he received them with a strange delight. Just like his wife, but how she was before the tears, and how she was before the years flew by, and how she was when she was beautiful. She signed the letter, all yours, babushka, 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 yeah, yeah. All yours, babushka, 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 yeah, yeah.
Babushka, babushka, yeah, yeah.
Bush. Babushka. Check out the video for that on YouTube. It's pretty funny. It's Kate and playing her husband as a double bass. And let's terminate things with my own Babushka song. It's all about infidelity and fooling a person incognito. This one of mine is called Master of Disguise.
Master of disguise. I'm a master of.
go. That is episode 114. Probably going to be the 22nd of October before I'm back again. Next week is too soon. The week after that, I will be in Monterey for work. Yay. So, the 22nd, episode 115. Join me then, won't you? Until then, ciao, ciao. And there we go. And we'll finish.